Hey folks, what is going on? This is BQ. This is the Impact Lounge YouTube channel, the number one place to be for the positive, passionate Impact wrestling fan. If it's your first time here, hit the subscribe button. You won't be disappointed. If you're a loyal subscriber, you probably have seen that I've kind of scaled back on the channel a little bit. I'm going to be focusing on reviews and interviews going forward for the most part. Not a lot of news, not a lot of rumors. Reason being is just my work schedule right now is way too crazy, and I just cannot keep up that kind of content for the channel. But if it's something important, I'm going to do my best to talk about it, and that's what I'm going to do right now. Before I say that, in the description of this video, if you've not checked out our last interview with Kongo Kong, please check that out. At the end of this video, you'll be able to click on it directly, but I'm going to put it in the description here as well. So definitely check out the Kongo Kong interview, and I'll be uploading the interview with Moose here very, very soon. But as far as the news goes that I want to talk to you about right now, this is via Iceman on the Twitch channel. You know, he has the podcast with Santino. I always for Anthony Morelli, I believe is his name. I know everyone still calls him Santino, and he hasn't been on the last 2 weeks, but on the podcast on Twitch, I think it's called Under the Lights or Behind the Lights. Shout out to Ken Basquet for hitting me up on Facebook with this news, though. He announced, and he said this is via his producers, that Slammiversary this year will be on the Global Wrestling Network. He doesn't mean it's going to be uploaded to the GWN. He means it's going to stream live for the paid subscribers. So if you're someone who pays $7.99 a month, you will be able to watch Slammiversary this year. So we will stand by for the official announcement from Impact Wrestling itself. But you know that the numbers for GWN went up quite a bit when it was featured on Table of Three on the WWE Network. They skyrocketed, and I think it's really going to continue to skyrocket now that Slammiversary will be streamed on it. And obviously the number of paid subscribers is going to go up, even if it's only for a month, you know, because some people are going to pay and then go right back to the free version. But it's going to get the numbers up, and should be more money in the pocket for Impact Wrestling, because obviously more people are probably going to have eyes on it now that it's going to be on the GWN. So this is really exciting news, and hopefully it streams without skips. You know, hopefully it's a nice, clear, and consistent stream. But it's really exciting news. You know, I never minded watching it on Fight, but, you know, paying $40 for a pay-per-view, a wrestling pay-per-view these days. You know, a lot of people don't want to do it. I don't really care, because Impact doesn't ask for your money a whole lot. So for me to pay $40, it's whatever. But this is good, and I think this is going to be an added motivator for them to maybe get a fourth pay-per-view in there. You know that they've been asking, what do you guys want to see for pay-per-views and TV specials and everything. So I think with the ability to stream on the network, I think we're going to see increased pay-per-views. I really think so. And hopefully this does get the revenue stream up. And then when that happens, they can do shorter tapings. In a perfect world for me, I would like to see them do a pay-per-view every other month. You know, say tapings is 6 months of television leading up to a pay-per-view. I think that's going to keep ratings up. And I think it would keep some decent revenue coming in, especially if every other month you knew you were going to get that spike in GWN subscribers. So we'll see what happens going forward. Let's stand by for the official announcement from Impact Wrestling regarding this. But via Iceman on Twitch, he said it will be on the GWN. If you haven't checked out, I believe it's Behind the Lights. If you haven't checked this out on Twitch, I believe it's on Wednesdays around like 3 or 4 Eastern. I think it's 4 Eastern. It's a 2-hour podcast that they do. They really do a good job. It's really, really professional. It's not like Josh Matthews and Sanjay when they're doing their podcast and it was like all sorts of horrendous sound quality. You know, this is a video stream. It's really professional. You know, they're set up almost like a late night talk show. The numbers for this on Twitch have been really, really bad. So if you're not able to stream it live, you know, maybe check it out when you get home or at night or something like that, because for me personally, the time that they stream it, I can't watch it at that time. That's a really difficult time to stream something. I wish they did it at night. I think numbers would go up quite a bit. But check the show out. At least give it one shot, and I think you guys will actually really like it. They talk about UFC, wrestling, you know, wrestling with all companies. And then they do a thing where they'll tell you three indie matches, and you get to vote on which one you want to see. So they'll play the match in its entirety and then kind of give you commentary through it. So it's really cool. Definitely check it out, folks, and get involved with the Twitch content and the GWN content. And if you haven't subscribed to the GWN, what are you waiting for? This is BQ. Thanks for checking me out. I'm going to catch you guys soon. Peace.